Oh, let's continue working with our theme. As you can see in my previous course, what you normally do, you go to the customizer. Most teams use of the customizer or if you create your own customizer, but still you can see some kind of customization options here. When we go to the customize store, you can get a look and feel here, and we have some problems. As you remember, I forgot to finish that in the list settings. We go to reading, and here you need to set up stuff. So the front page is, home, and the post page is blog. This should be done. This is very important. Save these changes. And now when we refresh the page, you can already see, this looks better now. Okay. Nothing's changed. Home, blog, home thingy. Now we go to appearance, customize, and let's go and change some stuff. As you can see, our menu is gone. We have two options. We have a menu option here, pointing to the same options as in the menu, or you can do it through here, but a different look and feel. We have a menu, look, the main menu, but it's not showing. Why is that? Because we have a different theme location. So remember to go always check this one here, press the mark there, save button, refresh, and now we have our menu back. So when you go to the shop and go to men, now you can see we have our products with a nice button here and some extra stuff. So go back to the customizer and let's go to the stuff first. So first option we have is a sidebar. Do you want a sidebar or not? I personally don't like a sidebar. But let's go to the men page. You can disable the sidebar site-wide. Is that what we want or not? Well, let's see if this theme has a template. As you can remember, pages have templates. When we go to the home page, you can see here we have a template option. There's a default template and a home page template. Now it's default, so it's the same for everything. But when we go to the home page and press update, now we go to home, you can see now the sidebar is gone on the home page, but it's not gone in the category page. This is what we want, okay? Because now the home page, we can do beautiful stuff, and here we can have a sidebar. I want to keep it. So let's go back to the customizer, and now we can choose the sidebar for shop pages to be shown or not. Well, do you want a sidebar, yes or no? I think I want the left sidebar. See, let's keep it like this. There's nothing in there yet. And I think you can make it smaller or bigger with this one. I think 3 is okay. Let's go back. The main styling, yes, select the logo. We have one here, if you want to use it, if you remember for the import. Now, you can see here, your logo is very big. I'm gonna show you later how to fix this. The top bar text, let's check first what this is. Just type some text here and see. Ah, there we have some top bar text, as you can see here on top. What you can do there is add some stuff like your email address, and maybe here, add your telephone number. See, you get some extra information on top. Search bar, yes, I want the search bar with social icons. Here it is. And I want to enable social icons as well. And just add your links to your stuff here, but you can do this to get. See, now you get some basic links here. Or if you want to remove the search bar, that's also fine. Press the save and publish once in a while. Oh, I'm sorry. Press the wrong button. Search bar social, site background, that's okay. Colors, site title color is black. Site description color is also simple. WooCommerce settings, when you go to the shop, the number of products displayed per page, 24. This looks cool. Number of products per row, 4. Okay, it's also cool. Title, I think this is also fine. Not gonna change anything here. The menu is what we already did. We can add widgets at the front page. As you can see, we did some very basic stuff and your shop already looks better. But now we got a big logo, that's an issue. But the main look and feel is there. We get a product category with a nice option here. If you choose this theme and you think, well, this is not for me, you can change another theme without losing all the settings we did before. Mainly we have to re-add the menu, but still. Because when working with this, maybe this is not what I want. Okay, so let's move on. In the next lecture, I'm going to show you how to switch to a different theme. And with that theme, we're going to work permanently.